Hi and welcome. I'm Year 12 student Michaela Zeiderdown.
And I'm Hannah. Welcome to MC Live Episode 4.
This will be our last show for 2020 and we've had some really good feedback, so hopefully we'll be back more with some more episodes.
We won't be back next year, but we're really excited to keep watching the show like you guys will be. And for now, we'd like to introduce our new segment, Fill Your Guts or Spill Your Guts.
Some Year 12s really had to fess up.
Plus, there will be a Term 3 review.
But first, we have our Year 12 ATAR drama student, Ellen Van Beek, with her original solo performance, Monday Morning and the Adolescent Brain.
At 5:45 a.m.
Attention brain, your meeting has commenced. Vanity has joined the meeting. Anxiety has joined the meeting. Depression has joined the meeting. Please do not tap the laptop screen. The conference has commenced.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining the meeting. So we have insomnia, anxiety, depression, and vanity with us. Great. Now, is motivation here? No? Okay, looks like we're going to be running without motivation again today. Now, Emma wakes up in 6 minutes and she's got a very big morning ahead. On the agenda, we have the Year 12 school photos, and then we have choir practice after school with St. Jude's, and then we have the essay due at midnight tonight.
Forgetfulness has joined the meeting.
Good morning, forgetfulness. Now, everyone remember, she is in Year 12 and this is Term 3. So we need to ensure that today goes completely off the rails and she looks like a total idiot in front of everyone that she knows. Now, forgetfulness, how did last night go? So I'm pretty sure that she left her uniform at her dad's house. So she's gonna have to wear her sister's one again today, which is very short and tight, which I'm sure Vanity would love, but ooh, perfect. Here's what I prepared earlier, just for the occasion. This is anxiety, so I will just tell her that everyone will think she's a tease and that she's going to get told off by teachers, and I'll flood her brain with deadlines. I'll remind her what a failure she is and how she's so incredibly incapable. Good depression, I like how we're working as a team here. So we have big black circles under the eyes, thanks to insomnia, and no uniform, thanks to forgetfulness. Stress, can you have a chat to the white blood cells and double up on the pus oozing out of that cold sore? Oh, great. And moving on to the choir practice after school with St. Jude's. Forgetfulness, did you have anything in mind?
This is a reminder that forgetfulness is on mute.
Sorry about that. So I was thinking that we could have her forget her history textbook in her locker. So then she has to go back to her locker to get her history textbook and then she's late to catch the bus. There was one other thing, but I can't remember. I'll remind her of what a failure she is and how she'll probably be yelled at by Dr. Beckham like she was last week. I'll drain her of her desire to do anything. So, when she arrives late, well, fashionably late, I'll help her with a good entrance. I'll have her walk into the choir room like this.
Jump the line to the front, you up the line, get what we want.
Wait, guys, this is a lot. Is this not a lot? I don't think it's necessary that Emma falls over. She could get seriously injured, and when we can't have that before the waste exams, and she can't go to St. Jude's because she'll get COVID. And don't tell me that I can't be in charge. I want to be in charge for once. It's not fair that you're in charge all of the time. Anxiety. We cannot have you throwing your ideas around like that all the time. Remember, I'm in charge of the entire body, and we cannot have you just take over like that. Now, moving on to the essay due at midnight tonight, I thought it would be great if we could have a 2-hour nap after choir practice. Now, fatigue. Where's fatigue? Fatigue! She must be asleep. Depression, can you remind fatigue about the nap, please? Thanks. So, when she wakes up, let's have a panic attack because it's all so close and she hasn't done anything, and then she won't be able to finish her assessment. And then I'll calm her down and tell her to have a pamper night. She can have a bath, do her hair, do her nails. She will look great. And the assignment will be forgotten.
This is a reminder that Emma's wake-up alarm will go off.
Oh, okay, everyone. Let's work together and completely destroy her today, okay?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So relatable. Can definitely say I may have been there a few times before.
Unfortunately, so have I. But for something different other than our usual busful karaoke, we have our Year 12 Fill Your Guts or Spill Your Guts.
Either answer the question or pay the consequences.
Hi, and welcome to Spill Your Guts or Fill Your Guts. Today we'll be playing with some Year 12s, and this is our food. We have Spam, anchovies with jam, rice, cheese, tuna and tomato sauce, hot and spicy beef jerky, oysters, and fried shallots. So who wants to start?
Gabby. Who is your favourite teacher?
My favourite teacher is Miss Stoney.
I pick the beef jerky.
rank the boys' scores you've had socials with or eat the hot beef jerky.
Eat the beef jerky, it looks so good.
Yeah.
You should smell it.
Do you have beef with any of the guys from the school?
That was so bad.
Ew.
Meaty
and fulfilling. Yeah, have a fish or not?
Let's give it a go.
I don't like
spicy. I don't like people watching them eat.
Yeah,
okay.
No, I don't like spicy.
You don't like it?
Not nice.
Oysters?
Oh,
yes. You have brought them in. What are yours?
Ask this question.
Which burger is better?
Oh no.
She's trapped. Oh,
yes.
Yeah,
I should not.
What?
I actually have one.
Oh, I can't. Okay,
No. Just a bite, Come on.
Okay, just a bite, a swallow.
It smells foul.
You're not doing it, you know.
Okay, Anita, this anchovy. Who is your least favourite teacher?
No!
So mean! Just have a bite, just come on.
You're shaking.
That's a lie.
We all do.
We all know it, so eat the fish.
Oh my god. Did it out?
Hey! It's okay, Harry Styles back is out too. Thank you, and we'll see you next time on Mercedes Lunchtime Live.
Oysters are foul.
I agree. I wonder what these hosts will bring us next time.
Term 3 has been super busy at Mercedes College, so let's have a look.
Term 3 at MC equals getting the most out of lessons and co-curricular activities.
So let's take a look at our Term 3 in review.
Let's start with Science Week. The Science Week celebrations involved students using virtual reality goggles to discover the wonders in the depths of the hidden oceans. They were also asked the question, what can we do to reduce waste? To be more environmentally conscious, there was a collection of single-use plastics where the girls were challenged to think of solutions to reduce their waste.
The Year 10 girls were guests at Trinity College Perth for their social, where their theme for the night was dynamic duos and trios. The winning Mercedes College outfit was a trio, who came in as the three blind mice. Congrats to Imogen, Evie and Caitlin. The evening started by visiting the ballroom dancing skills learnt in Year 9, followed by DJ and a disco. It was a fabulous night enjoyed by all.
Term 3 means a lot of exams and assessments, and over Year 12 drama students have been putting together outstanding performances, such as the one you saw earlier in the show. Head of Arts and drama teacher, Mrs. Kathleen Cox, led the students through the creation of their original solo performances in preparation for their practical exams. Such great talent!
Thank you to everyone who attended Music at Stedford, led by Miss Catherine Clarnett. It was an excellent day in which the girls had the opportunity to perform to an audience in a supportive and encouraging setting. Well done to all the performers from Year 7 to 12, and a big thanks to the Music Department for another successful event.
The Year 12 prefects invited the prefects from Trinity College to their annual fundraiser. This year, a soccer match for the McGrath Foundation. Everyone got into the pink spirit and had some fun, and we beat the boys, of course. But if you ask them, they might say differently. What an exciting term. And sadly, it's over, and our final term as MC students.
So we'd just like to say a massive thank you to our class of 2020 and a really big, sad, nostalgic goodbye.
We're really going to miss you all next year. It's going to be so different walking around places and not seeing all your faces every day.
And to leave with that, we'll say a quote from our Year 8 book that we did in Year 8, The Giver. If you were to be lost in the River Jonas, your memories would not be lost with you. Memories are forever. And with that, that brings us to the end of Lunchtime Live episode 4.
It's been fantastic to be with you throughout this program this year, and we'll be certainly tuning in to stay in touch with everything that you guys do over the next year. Till then, thanks for having us, and bye.